या वी कर्स गॉड, वी कर्स गॉड, क्या गेम बना के रखा है नो? दुनिया बनाने वाले क्या तेरे मन में समाया, काय को दुनिया बनाई, पीपल कर्स गॉड ओनली. इट्स अ फंडामेंटल क्वेश्चन दैट दे आर आस्किंग, बट दे डोंट नो हाउ टू डील विद दैट क्वेश्चन. सो द आंसर्स आर देयर इन भगवद गीता और स्क्रिप्चर्स. एनी अदर? In case you are writing, take your own time. And maybe someone, can you just go around collecting and bring them here, chits? Yes. Palmistry and astrology, they can tell you based on the everything in this creation is harmonized. The planetary situations, the birth time of a person, the past activities that he has performed according to which he is getting a certain birth, and certain of his past karmas reaction that are going to come. And those things can be foretold. But while they are being foretold to you, how are you going to react to them is not controlled by God. For example, it may be destined that somebody is going to get some disease. That doesn't mean that everything else about him is fixed in his life. I'll give a simpler example. Say you purchased a ticket to go to Chicago. Now, once you sit inside the plane, you have to go to Chicago. You are destined to go to Chicago. You cannot suddenly jump up in the plane and say, "Hey, मेरे को Chicago नहीं जाना, मेरे को Japan लेके चलो." वो बोलेंगे भैया शांति से नीचे बैठो. पहले तुमको free will दिया था, क्या choose करना है. तो choice एक बार कर दिया, अभी destiny fixed हो गया. Chicago उतर के Japan जाओ, हमको problem नहीं है, लेकिन अभी destiny fixed है. You get my point? So you used or misused your free will, your destiny became fixed. Now within that destiny, you still have free will. In the plane, what you do is still within your hand. You can drink, whiskey or rum, or you can drink milk, or you can make friendship with a business tycoon sitting next to you, and big business will wait, you when you get down the airport, or you may go and hijack the plane, and then. Police will wait for you, once you get down from the plane. So within the destiny, there is free will. You understand? And then what you do with that choice within that destined thing will either free you more or bind you more in future. So destiny, free will. It's like walking. They go simultaneously. Every moment in our life, we are making choices that is fixing destiny. But within that destined thing, now we again made right choices, then either you become bound or you become liberated. That choice is always there.
So, God doesn't fix for everyone that you have to go for this. You only make choices.
You have earlier made choices. See, sometimes what we do, is that, let's say, अगर किसी को कुर्ता बनाने के लिए टेलर को दे दिया उसने और बाद में उसका माइंड चेंज हो गया, बोला मेरे को सफारी बना के चाहिए. तो बोले भैया अभी काट के हो गया, सब स्टिचिंग हो गया, अभी क्या तुमको सफारी बना के देंगे. तो आप लोग वापस चॉइस करते समय वापस अच्छे से चॉइस करो, करेंगे तुम्हारे. सो लाइक दैट नेचर इज गिविंग अस रिएक्शन फॉर वॉट चॉइसिस वी हैव अर्लियर मेड. यू कॉन्ट ब्लेम गॉड फॉर दैट ऑफ वॉट इज कमिंग नाउ इन अवर लाइफ. And now within this choice, what we are going to choose will decide further consequences. So that is why we have to be always careful of the choices that we make.
So,
Yes. If you worship God, it can burn your karma to ashes. It's like somebody has even committed a sin like murder and he is being given life sentence. 25 saal kala pani. He is rotting in some Tihar jail or something. But if he behaves good in the jail, he sets a good track record, he becomes a law-abiding citizen within the jail, and one fine day he appeals to the President of India, I'm sorry, I made a mistake, just leave me alone. Then uska 12 saal hi ho gaya, baki 13 saal ko, they just erase it and they send him out. So God, being the supreme president over everything, if you become a law-abiding citizen in this world, he can free you of your bad karma even earlier than what you deserve.
Is important, or changing your attitude means again becoming a good person and
both are important. Both are important.
Then why God has done like this, that okay, if you take my name, I will
God is not a self-aggrandizing person. We superimpose our personality on him because we have experience of all kinds of vicious people in this world. So we generally tend to think that God must be also another autocratic tycoon, you know, who is sitting at the helm of everything, you know, controlling everybody. You surrender to me, submit to me, otherwise you see what happens to you, you know. God is not that type of person. God is a loving father. Just like your father tells you, don't do this, do that, stay at home, eat this, don't eat that. Is he controlling you? He is controlling in the sense that he loves you. So when God gives some instructions, like he tells you to chant his holy name, for example, why is he doing that? Is God going to get some benefit out of some soul sitting in some corner of the universe, you know, chanting his names? Do you think it's a grand accomplishment for God or something like that? It's nothing. But at the same time, I give that example. The hand feeds the stomach. Who benefits? The hand benefits. The nourishment goes back to the hand. So God is independent enjoyer. He doesn't need us for his enjoyment. He's Swayampurna. He's Atma Rama. Is fully self-satisfied. We need his help for our... So this is eternally the arrangement that the Purana and Amsha, they simultaneously coexist. But Amsha is eternally dependent on God.
Sometimes it is said that whether you worship God or not, the mercy is for everyone. Like he is having the loving feeling, for caring feeling for everyone.
How do you know somebody is loving God? They're sentimental, I guess. One who follows desire of God, who follows his instruction, he is loving God. It is not just a matter of saying, I love God and do any nonsense in the life. So there are people who say, I don't worship God, I don't care anything about spirituality, I do whatever I like, but I am sentimentally, you know, I accept God and I love him. It's just a theory. If you love someone, then you work to please that person. And that love is expressed through service. So, God is not a self-aggrandizing person who wants us to serve him because he gets some sadistic pleasure out of it. But actually speaking, we need to serve him because our eternal connection with him is that of loving service. And that, when revived, gives us joy in return. What about eating non-veg? How karmas continue? As it is told in Bible that you, human being, are superior and can eat anything you want. I agree overeating is not good, but sometimes once in a week. How is it bad for spirituality? So, I earlier addressed this issue. We should try and minimize violence for our personal living in this world. It is not that if there is no food to eat, you can't eat animals. Because your purpose of life, self-preservation, is accompanied by self-realization, God relationship. So in that context, it is okay. But when you are not so threatened, you should simply try and minimize the violence as far as possible so that you don't get bad karma. Because the amount of pain that you inflict comes back to you in your life. So if somebody is already having a culture that endorses meat eating on certain occasion, they still can practice the essence of spirituality, which is ABCD. The details of working out the practices can be sorted out later. So we have to first focus on the essence and then work on setting right the details. Is religion nowadays a good salesmanship? Maturing type ego who deliver himself better well. How to choose religion? Does religion really exist? Wow, what a fundamental question. So, let's talk about religion. In Sanskrit, the term is called dharma, right? This comes from a root, dhru, dharayate, which means that which holds or sustains your existence. Dharma does not mean religion. Or dharma in Sanskrit does not mean any kind of faith. That's not the meaning of the term dharma. It's a shocking news. Dharma means intrinsic quality of a substance that cannot be separated from its existence. For example, sugar is sweet. So sweetness is dharma of sugar. Fire is hot. So heat is the dharma of fire. Is there fire without heat? Is there sweet sugar without sweetness? There's no such a thing. Because if you remove that dharma, intrinsic quality, the substance has no meaning. So we are all living beings. What is the dharma of all living beings? Be they humans, animals, whatever. This is a fundamental question. What is the dharma of all living beings? Let us not talk Christianity, Hinduism, Islam. That is not our discussion. What is common feature, intrinsic quality in every living being, which cannot be separated from their existence? That quality is to love and to serve. You understand? To love someone, and the expression of love comes through service. Even in a tiger's body, you will see there is love and service. This quality of the living being cannot be separated from its existence. That is why this is our dharma. See, somebody can change his religion. Somebody can become from Hindu to, you know, Christian, or Christian to Islam, or whatever. This can be changed. Can this be changed? It cannot be changed. Now comes the next question. Whom should I love and serve to experience fulfillment of that desire? And that personality is God. He is the all perfect person. He is full of all opulences. He is all attractive. He is having all strength, all beauty, all knowledge, all wisdom, all renounced and attractive. That is why in Sanskrit the word is Krishna. Krishna means all attractive. Krish means to attract, na means completely. One who attracts completely. Why does he attract completely? Because he has got all these wonderful qualities. All mercy, all knowledge, all beauty, all fame, all wealth belongs to him. So to love and serve God is our actual dharma. Now this personality that we are supposed to love and serve, different religions may call him by different names. Like Jehovah means all merciful. Allah means almighty, one who possesses all powers. And Krishna means all attractive. So when we talk about dharma, what are we talking about? Are we talking about this? No. We are talking about this. And this is the meaning of true spirituality. Sometimes we unnecessarily become fanatic in the name of religion because we have not captured the essence of it. We are simply wallowing in the dirt of our own ego in the name of religion. And that is why people have difficulty appreciating and practicing even their own religion. Not mine, someone else's. So, to love and serve is our dharma, and this cannot be changed. And is it some salesmanship that you need to have a guru? Is guru some, you know, what they call dalal? You take this and you give me commission. Is that something, that kind of an arrangement? No. If you think about it, even to learn basic material knowledge, we need a guru, teacher. Karate, tabla, physics, maths, this, that. Why not we should have a guru to teach us bona fide spirituality? Can we all figure it out all by ourselves? Simply by reading books, can somebody become a doctor? Why there is a body of doctors that authorizes, that tests, that conducts various things, and then authorizes this person as a doctor? Because that procedure helps one become more capable, more well situated in spirituality. So guru is not a middleman between us and God. Guru is actually a transparent via media. Guru takes no credit whatsoever for transforming us. Nor is he after any kind of self-aggrandizement. It's not that guru wants worship for himself. Just like when American ambassador comes to India, he's given respect like that of American president, because he represents an entire country. Similarly, pure devotees of God who come from spiritual world into this world to reclaim fallen souls back to spiritual world are given respect like that of God, because they represent an entire culture. And that is not that meant for their aggrandizement. It is meant for our benefit. So if a guru becomes addicted or attached to money, followers, wealth or prestige, he no more remains a guru. He's a con guru. It's like a daku guru. Con guru. And we should know what are the symptoms of a true guru. That's also very important. The first and foremost symptom of a true guru is that he comes in a disciplic chain of succession, parampara. He doesn't whimsically speak anything. It is not that he says, this is my opinion. This is not another, what you call, competition for speculation. Who do you think God is? There is no need to speculate. So, parampara. Second quality of a guru is that he must be an acharya. Now, I'm using Sanskrit terms because I come from a certain culture, but I hope other people from Christianity, Islam can appreciate the content that I'm saying. Acharya means one who follows his own words. He walks his talk. If I'm telling you no meat eating, no gambling, no illicit sex, no intoxication, I must follow it myself. If I'm telling you chant God's holy names, I must follow it myself. It is not that my words are for you and my actions are for myself. That doesn't work. So, acharya. The third quality of a guru is that one time George Harrison, one of the Beatles musician, he asked Prabhupada, how do you know who is bona fide guru? And Prabhupada gave an interesting answer because he comes from a hippie background. Prabhupada said, just see who is most addicted to God. It's an interesting answer. Just see who is most addicted to God. He is guru. And for that matter, when Krishna and Rama, they come in this world, they accept a guru. They don't claim, you know, I can get knowledge independent of him. Just to set an example that we also need a guru in our life. So these are some important considerations regarding acceptance of a guru. How do you handle people who treat you wrongly due to jealousy? I hope you remember modeling, mentoring, organizing, teaching. That's the way we handle anybody in this world. We don't get on their case. You can get on people's case. You know how? You kill them with your love. You understand? If somebody is jealous of you, actually jealousy or envy is nothing but indirect appreciation. You agree? They actually appreciating what you are doing, but they are indirect about it. Similarly, when we are envious of somebody, we are having indirect appreciation. Why not make it direct? Kya problem hai? In fact, if you appreciate good qualities, you develop good qualities instead of envying them. So, if you have to ever deal with somebody who is on our case in terms of jealousy, we kill them. How? With love. And what is the language of love? Modeling, mentoring, organizing. That is the language of love. We should become good at that language rather than verbal abuse and you know tu tu me me marathi mantala baacha baachi mantat people do not needed
it doesn't lead anywhere
huh
means if you
yes it doesn't lead anywhere correct what is the difference between chanting mantras while doing our other day to day activities every moment and chanting mantras by sitting in a secluded spot and saying it aloud yeah you can so chanting mantras can be done both ways by giving exclusive time where we do it as a serious concentrated business or throughout the day when we are working like we are cooking or cleaning or whatever we try and remember the names of the Lord both are wonderful but in order to do the second thing to be unconsciously conscious of God you have to practice being consciously conscious of God you understand to become unconsciously conscious you have to first become consciously conscious can we really confidently say like that kuch kuch log aage bolte hai ki hum kya swami ji 24 ghanta jap karte hai andar hi andar chalta rehta hai hare krishna 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 you know saans lete hai hare krishna saans chhod de hare krishna I called that person and told why are you lying to me why are you cheating yourself kya mil raha hai tumko isse you really think you are such a great soul pure devotee of God that you don't stop chanting ever in your whole throughout the day 24 hours this is cheating itne sare gande vichar bhare rehte hain kya kya chalta rehta hai and we say we are a pure devotee so I said don't deceive yourself it is better that we make a spiritual practice that gives us a regular boost to even unconsciously think of God just like there is you know priming required for a pump to draw water and then it continuously draws the water so first we need to learn by making an effort at it so we chant a fixed number of rounds every day to get accustomed to the process of chanting and it is not to show off to anybody that I do this much and I do that much it's not for that purpose the counting is meant for disciplining the mind if we don't discipline the mind our mind will cheat us and it has been cheating very nicely all along so we don't want to get cheated by our mind so that is why we have some fixed number of you know and the rosary beads or namaz even they count right it's not like it's indiscriminate anything and everything so in our culture also Vedic culture we count and chant so we should do that on a regular basis so because we have already reached to the topic of mantra let's chant it and conclude for the day I think there are many other questions we would take them in person after the class So again I mention this that this mantra meditation is a very very important tool in the quiver of your self development plan if you really want to develop yourself powerfully you know so sunar ki ek lohar ki you heard that so you may read 100 self help books you may do this that 100 things won't work but this one thing will work and that is chanting God's holy names on a daily basis so if you belong to other religious denominations please do chant the names of Allah or God in your own way no issues if you already belong to the Vedic tradition please chant this Hare Krishna mantra this chanting is the most sublime method to revive our original God consciousness and all our questions that we are asking about God his presence our doubts about him will be answered if you simply chant all this is theory and what we do is practical chanting God's holy name so practical is needed to realize the theory that we talk about so let us do that 3 P's posture pronunciation prayerful mood posture means we sit erect not leaning over anything pronunciation means we utter clearly and hear attentively we should not allow our mind to get distracted it's a practice of concentration mind generally has 2 wings that it flies with the past and the future it goes back to the past or goes back to the future you cut off those wings and make him land in the present Tell the mind one thing at a time, one mantra now. And if you make this as a practice, two things will increase, dharana shakti and ekagrata shakti. Ability to comprehend and hold a subject in our head and ability to concentrate in life. So it will help us in the throughout the day, various activities that we do, if we chant nicely. And finally, prayerful mood. This mantra is a prayer. O Hare, O Krishna, please engage me in your service. Let me know you, let me love you, let me serve you. That is the meaning of this prayer. So let us do it together. And you can count on your fingers. It's generally 12, you can count on one hand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 12. And if you chant 9 times, this sequence it becomes 108. Go and ask PT Usha, when she is doing her laps, does she keep a track of time and how many times in a day she will complete her run? They do it by numbers, because that is how you go on to become an expert eventually. It is not a number game, it is just to get you acclimatized to the constant practice. We'll explain the meaning behind that, but right now we will focus on chanting. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda. Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Together. Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Thank you very much. So before we conclude for the day, I would take this opportunity to thank each and every one of you for your sweet, enthusiastic, attentive and introspective participation in last 4 days. It has been a great learning for me to come here and share these things with all of you. I found that this is one of the most enthusiastic and learning oriented group in this school, and I wish you all the best, that you practice all these wonderful principles that you have learned here. They are not part of any particular, you know, religion or anything like that. These are universal principles that we are talking here about. And I wish you especially all the best that you may start practicing spiritual culture even more intensely in your life. Unfortunately, in India, in the name of secularism, people don't follow any religion. It's an interesting phenomenon. Secularism means you follow your religion, I will follow my religion, and we will not conflict with each other. We respect each other's rights. That is meaning of secularism. But in schools or wherever we go in general, people tell, oh, Swamiji, don't talk about God. What do you mean don't talk about God? If you banish God, you banish all goodness also along with it in life. So people should be given a chance to present and at the same time also a chance to practice the way they would like to practice. And that individuality has to be respected. So if you find that children or their parents are eager to practice spiritual culture, whichever culture, Islam, Christianity, Hinduism, doesn't matter. You should happily allow them to do so. That is the meaning of secularism. Not that, you know, you don't do this and you don't do that. So I found that this was one of the most open groups that we could ever come and interact with, and not having any bias or fanaticism, quite open-minded. Also, we have some of these books. Yesterday, many of you are having so many books that you wanted, we had got exhausted. We have brought today in Kannada also. And especially today, we have some prasadam that we have got from temple for all of you. So as you go out on a table, you'll find some nice drones arranged. Please pick up your small plate and go and have some prasadam. Prasad is non-different from God himself. It comes in the form of food. And it has tremendous spiritual potency. And we especially request you to remember the formula that I gave on day number one. Half an hour a day, 2 hours a week, and 10 days a year. Do good to yourself. If nothing you remember from this whole 4 days, no problem. At least remember to do this. And give exclusive time to yourself to develop your own self-development properly. And I especially want to thank our Mishra Madam, the principal and leader of this whole school effort here. She has been a great help and also a great inspiration for conducting this program. And also I thank all of you once again. Hare Krishna.